This gap has come because I don't get any proper content to come back again. So that was the reason. And then of late, I stopped film acting and I went to politics. Yeah. So for 10 years I was there. And again, in 2016, I started working. So I thought with this film, I should come back to Bollywood. So that's the reason.
It's great to have you back, sir. Farhan, sir, my question is to you. And first of all, congratulations for presenting another epic movie after KGF.
Thank you very much.
So my question to you, sir, it's the film is releasing on 2nd of October, and along with your friends Hrithik Roshan's War. So what's your take on that?
Well, there's also Tiger Shroff, who's my friend.
Yeah, sure.
So let's call all my friends. No? But the fact is that, you know, I think now we should go beyond this whole thing of like two films cannot release on a day. I think there's enough screens, there's enough of an audience for two films to release on a day and do well. The people who have made that film are absolutely happy with the film that they've made. I'm sure it's a great film. We wish them all the best, as I'm sure that they wish us. And we just hope that the audiences will go in and see both films. You know, that's what we can hope for. I don't look at it in any other way beyond that.
Here at the center. Hi. My name is Anketa and I'm from Republic. First of all, amazing teaser. And I got goosebumps. So congratulations to all the team for that. My question to you is, Chiranjeevi ji, aapse. You know, two mega stars together coming for the first time, Chiranjeevi ji and Amitabh Bachchan together. How was it on the sets? Too much of talent flowing, I can say?
He's my real life mentor. And it happened even in the film. And I feel there is only one and only megastar, that is Amitabh Bachchan. That is nobody's
so
near to him. So I don't consider, but thank you. You mentioned that. And working with him is an amazing experience. So I'm really indebted to him a lot because just I asked when my director wanted him to be my guru in this film. So that character is a special character. So he insists me, if it is Amitabh Bachchan, nothing like that. I said, I try. I just called him. I want to talk to him. No, tell me please what you want. I want you to be in my film. Ram Charan is making this Saira, and it's a wonderful subject. And I want you to be my guru character. It's a special character. Maybe maximum 1 week time will take. He said immediately, Chiranjeevi, you don't ask anything, you never ask anything. Since you are asking, I said, I'll say yes. And he, so great, and immediately he responded. He said, send your team to me, I want to discuss the rest of the things. And I sent director and other people, I sent them. And immediately he said yes. I'm so happy, really, my heartfelt thanks to the Indian megastar, Amitabh Bachchanji.
Thank you so much, sir. I think it'll be a treat to watch both of you together. Thank you.
Hi, Ritesh. Ritesh here. There's a question for you. You got us, you know, you guys got us KGF, and you presented the entire film in a grand way, and now you guys are part of this grand film. So what's the selection process? How do you guys select, you know, these films? And secondly, will we see you producing a South Indian film, a collaboration, you know, in a big way with Hindi film actors and this some presenting in a much grander way?
Like I said, firstly, I think the content when Charan, Anil spoke to us, and Charan had this idea of, you know, taking the film beyond just the South market and the South languages. I saw the trailer and like the teaser, which you're seeing now, I think it's a story which was of an unsung hero. It's like the first rebel against the British set in the 18th century. So I really liked what I saw. And then he took me through, I had not seen the film at that point. He took me through what the film was and I saw various portions of it and I was completely like in love with it. And I said, okay, this is something we should do. And I was glad that he, you know, like chose us to actually present the film. So it worked the other way. After seeing the material, we were really hopeful that he'll say that you guys should present it. So thank you. But that was there. And yes, why not? If we get a script and we can collaborate on a film, which right from the script level, rather than just coming on, we are completely open to that.
Hi, Farhan, on your left. On your left, hi. Hi, Faridun from Balunangama. So Farhan, you're saying that there are enough screens that we have. See, we are having around 5,000 screens for Hindi. And you've experienced it with Rais and...
Right. I think your question is very detailed. You should ask Anil Thadani this question.
Okay. I think I can ask both of you and Ritesh as well. I think Anil Thadani can answer as well. So the idea is that even with Rais and Kabil came together, so there was a day when I think you guys had around 26 crores in a day, and it was running to capacity. If there were more screens, you could have done more business. We've seen it in Mission Mangal and Batla House. Mission Mangal Sunday was extraordinary. But if more screens were there, the business would have been higher. So what efforts do you think should be done to just raise the number of screens? Because China is way ahead of us, and we are just not doing enough, maybe.
You have multiple questions in your first question, huh? So we'll have to think.
And you've also answered it in your question.
No, but I think ultimately you guys will have to take the initiative. We can say, but the initiative has to come from you guys.
You know, see, regarding the theaters, you're absolutely right. It is something we've, when we went and met our government recently, just before the elections, and when the GST issue was there, and we went and spoke to them, and I think they have understood what happens with cinemas, and what, especially in your rural city towns, because there are, either we are over-screened in Mumbai city and Delhi, where you'll have more screens, and there are a lot of places where we don't have screens. Yeah. So I think they've understood that. And like China, like you're absolutely right, China and India were on par till 2011 when we had the same average number of screens for the population, and they have obviously grown a lot. So I think, yes, there is a plan in place. But again, when you are talking about Rais or you're talking about Kabil, which released the same day, I think both were good films. If somebody went and saw Kabil on Thursday, they went and saw Rais the next day. So it's not that I did not get tickets, and there was one box office you mentioned was 25 crores and the other was... I think as long as both films are something which they want to watch, they'll go and watch it. It's not that because I've seen one, I won't see the other. Right? So I don't think we have that issue of worrying. Like even what Farhan said earlier, both will be good films. People will want to watch both. I mean, I'm sure you must have gone to in a week and watched two movies, right? You wouldn't only go to one film if they were there.
It's also about accessibility. Many a times people want to watch it, but the cinema screens are not, especially in the smaller cities, as you've rightly said.
Yeah, but you can go next day.
The cinema screens are less. They're not enough cinema screens, maybe, and because of that, people are unable to see it.
So I think they'll watch it the next day, and if it's not available on that screen, I'm sure it'll be available. It's not that it's never happened that in the same town or in the same pin code, you'll not find another screen. I don't think that's ever happened. So it's, at the most, you'll be a little more of effort. And I think if the movie is that exciting, you'll put in that little extra effort till we can have more screens like China, right?
So Mr. Thadani, you'd like to say something to that?
So I think the capacities actually come into play only for that one day, which is a holiday. The rest of the weekdays, there is ample room for two or maybe even three films to survive. So. Yeah, but if there were more screens, it would be better. So I think that's for the exhibitors to answer that question.
Who's next? Sure. That's
okay. Congratulations to the entire team. The trailer is superb. It looks fantastic. My question is to Tamanna. Tamanna, like, how does it really feel to be on the center and all among all the great men? You have been quite lucky to do Bahubali, now such a big film again. What's your experience?
I'd really like to first of all thank Suri sir, Surinder Reddy, who's sitting here. Main inke saath iske pehle kaam kar chuki hoon, and. जब भी उन्होंने मुझे किसी भी किरदार के लिए बुलाया है हमेशा कुछ अलग करने के लिए बुलाते हैं एंड फॉर मी इट वाज ऑलवेज अ ड्रीम सिंस आई एंटर्ड द साउथ इंडियन फिल्म इंडस्ट्री कि कब मैं चिरंजीवी सर के साथ काम करूंगी एंड वो इस फिल्म से पूरा हो रहा है आई कांट आस्क फॉर मोर बिकॉज जब एक टीजर में एक अपना ऐसा शॉट देखती हूँ तो लगता है अगर ये ही एक शॉट होता मेरा फिल्म में तो भी मेरे लिए काफ़ी है तो थैंक यू चिरू सर फॉर मेकिंग मी अ पार्ट ऑफ दिस फिल्म इट्स एक्सट्रीमली स्पेशल एंड चरण आई वर्क विथ हिम यू नो ही इज पुट इन हिज हार्ट एंड सोल टू सी दिस प्रोजेक्ट कम टू लाइफ एंड यू नो गेट एवरीथिंग दैट इट नीड्स I also would really, really like to mention Shishmita, who has done the costumes for the film. Humne kafi kaam kiya, har ek look ke liye. She's sitting right here. She's really like, jab main mirror mein dekhti thi, to mujhe lagta tha ki haan, this is Lakshmi. So that's what she made me feel on the set. And mera apna kirdar nibana bahut aasan ho gaya, kyunki main pehle hi Lakshmi jaise dikh rahi thi, to phir on set I felt like Lakshmi. And yeah, each and every one who's a part of the film, I worked with Vijay, Ravi sir ke saath kabhi kaam, humne kaam kiya nahi, humne kabhi kaam nahi kiya saath mein, kiya hai nahi, inko itne baar dekha kaise lag raha hai ki inke saath bhi kaam kiya hai,
humne mujhe shayad pehle
pehle bahut pehle
bahut pehle
bahut pehle. So it's just such a huge cast, and thank you guys, you've made this possible, I think, for getting this film, presenting it to the Hindi audiences. Who better than you guys to bring this this really, really amazing story out there to the Hindi audiences. So yeah, I mean, it's like a dream come true.
Yeah, Farhan and Ritesh, after KGF, like, you become more confident, like, you know, like after success of KGF, you become more confident to bring more regional film in to Bollywood.
No, it's not really a question of more or less confidence. I mean, you eventually believe in what it is that you are, what you have lying in front of you. So the way this film has been put together, just really the vision behind it is something that gives us a lot of confidence. And the belief that the core team has in the film, the way that they really have cut no corners in presenting it and making it an absolutely riveting, entertaining piece for the viewers, that gives you confidence. So it's not about what you've done before, what you're going to do in the future. It really is about just this film.
Hi, Ram. Firstly, kindly walk us through your character in the film, and secondly, why are you shying away from Hindi films? We want to see you in Hindi films. What's the reason for that?
Hi. My part is just being a producer. I've not done anything apart from that. I want to take the opportunity to thank all this great stars and cast we had put together. It wouldn't have been possible if it's not my dad and the love they have for him, and they wanted to be part of this journey, which is his dream project, and they all recognize that, and it is very kind of all the artists here to help me and put this cast together. And secondly, I've not shied away. I'm not really, like dad said, it's all about the content. Coming with the right content matters a lot end of the day for any actor, and hopefully next year I'm coming back with Rajmouli Garu's next project after, right now we're shooting for that. Hopefully that'll be my comeback, RRR.
Well, best wishes for that. And Sudeep, you are working with, you're working with this film with so many megastars, and you know, this is a grand film which is coming next month, and then you will be having Dabang 3 with Salman Khan. So this year is like a superstar year for you.
You said it yourself, so I guess made my answer easy. One is, we should always be lucky to be a part of a fraternity like film industry, which showcases us in different parts where we do not actually belong. Second, connection to such people whom we have seen growing up. Wonderful, I mean, it's, as I said, properties are one side in Saira. Actors are also equally as many as properties. So many, you know. Actually, I don't know whether there were any kind of vanity vans or any cars left in Hyderabad when we went. There are certain times in this particular set, sir. Set was only a very small one. I mean, of course, after the extension, it will be much bigger. But we had to pass a huge traffic to reach there from the gate, you know. That was something by itself, you know, where we are heading. So, you know, kind of you start getting mentally prepared where we are going. And once you go there, I guess the platform, the producers, and especially Ram, I mean, he's an actor himself, I guess, and if somebody should have a son, they should have like him, you know, who can make his father's dream come true to such an extent. It is lovely, sir, to be called. Yeah, we all have our own platforms where we belong, but stepping out of that, coming here, doing something because somebody else needs you, And trying to be submissive towards somebody's dream is much more fulfilling than what we dream ourselves. Same thing goes with the Bang 3 also. So I guess it's been a beautiful thing that you're wanted everywhere and you're called.
I have here.
Early 90s. So till 2007, I was in the film field only. So after that, I stopped acting. Again, I entered 2016. In this 10 years time, lot of change I have seen in the films. And when I'm leaving, there was a negative and positive clapboard and all these things. Nowadays, there's no such things are existing. So I felt when I was doing my 150th film, as a newcomer doing the first film, it was a different atmosphere, a different scenario, even at the time of exhibitions, I mean, in the theaters also. Totally, film has gone, projectors have gone. And that could change, but the content, the sentiment, it doesn't change at all. I trust the emotion of the film, the soul of the film carries from ages to even now, and it goes on like that. That change I didn't find. Only physical appearance, physical changes I've seen, but not the content. That's good.
Everyone. It's definitely not the same. The man is completely different once he puts his makeup on. That is, in few minutes, he completely transforms. And because I can't handle that man once he's on makeup, I keep my sisters at home. He's better off handled by the women of the house.
Thank you so much for producing this film and bringing it to us. And I have to ask everybody to put your hands up together for this man who has defined an era of Telugu cinema, massive influence on an entire generation of film personalities and cinegoers together, taking the audience into visual treats every time he came on screen, a man of the masses in the true sense of it. Coming back to cinema after almost a decade, keeping the audience still in awe through his style, skill and charisma, a megastar then, a megastar now, a mega star forever. Can we please put our hands up together for Chiranjeevi, sir? Very good afternoon, sir. It is an honor to share the stage space with you.
Thank you.
I have to say, you're just looking younger by the minute, and it is... I don't know. What do you do? We don't know. We don't even want to know that. So I'll just get into the drill. I'll just get into the questions. What did it take to become Saira Narasimhareddy?
It is an untold story about an unsung hero. So I want to bring this content to Pan India, because all the Indians should know about Narasimhareddy. It was lying with me, this story, since almost 1.5 decades. Because of the budget constraints, I couldn't dare to make this movie. Now Charan and Saira, Surendra Reddy, they came forward to make this movie at Pan India level. I'm so happy. Finally, my dream came true.
Sir, after 10 years, you're coming back to the film industry. After 10 years, you're coming back into a film. And the Hindi audience is also going to get a glimpse of the superstar, the megastar that you have. What message would you like to give to the Hindi audiences?
Yeah, this is the story every Indian should see. That's what I told. And I feel it is my responsibility to bring this story at India level. And since I have the beautiful content with me, I thought this is the best time to come to Bollywood as well as all other Indian languages. So Narasimha Reddy made me to come back again into this Pan India.
We're just happy, sir. That's all I have to say. We're very glad, very happy, ecstatic for the release of the film. We are going to ask this massive star cast and the producers to just take a tiny seat over here so that we can show the teaser to the entire media. And then, of course, open the questions. You will be able to take questions. You will be able to take pictures after also. So we'll see the preview, and then after that, we'll do the photo op. So if you could just take a seat, thank you very much. The producers, Vijay Sethupathi, Tamanna Sudeep, Ravi Kishan, Rajivan sir, Amit Trivedi, Surendra Reddy, Farhan Akhtar, Ritesh Sidwani, Anil Tadani, Ram Charan, Chiranjeevi sir. Could we get the first question for the team? The mic's coming to you.
First of all, congratulations to the entire team. This is Simran Singh here from First Post. The teaser looks epic from each and every frame. So my question to Megastar. Sir, it's good to have you back on screen, and this is the, I guess, after 1992, Aaj Ka Gundra, this is the Hindi film that we are watching. So what's the reason behind this absence, sir?
I don't know why this gap has come, because I don't get any proper content to come back again. So that was the reason, and then of late, I stopped film acting and I went to politics. Okay. So for 10 years I was there. And again, in 2016, I started working. So I thought with this film, I should come back to Bollywood. So that's the reason.
It's great to have you back, sir. Farhan, sir, my question is to you. And first of all, congratulations for presenting another epic movie after KGF.
Thank you very much.
So my question to you, sir, it's the film is releasing on 2nd of October, and along with your friends, Hrithik Roshan's War. So What's your take on that?
Well, there's also Tiger Shroff, who's my friend. So let's call all my friends. But the fact is that, you know, I think now we should go beyond this whole thing of like two films cannot release on a day. I think there's enough screens, there's enough of an audience for two films to release on a day and do well. The people who have made that film are absolutely happy with the film that they've made. I'm sure it's a great film. We wish them all the best, as I'm sure that they wish us. And we just hope that the audiences will go in and see both films. You know, that's what we can hope for. I don't look at it in any other way beyond that.
Here at the center. Hi. My name is Anketa and I'm from Republic. First of all, amazing teaser and I got goosebumps. So congratulations to all the team for that. My question to you is, Chiranjeevi ji, aapse. You know, two mega stars together coming for the first time, Chiranjeevi ji and Amitabh Bachchan together. How was it on the sets? Too much of talent flowing, I can say.
He is my real life mentor, and it happened even in the film. And I feel there is only one and only megastar, that is Amitabh Bachchan. That is nobody's
so
near to him. So I don't consider, but thank you. you mentioned that, and working with him is an amazing experience. So he's, I'm really indebted to him a lot, because just I asked when my director wanted him to be my guru in this film. So that character is a special character. So he insisted me, if it is Amitabh Bachchan, nothing like that. I said, I try. I just called him. I want to talk to him. No, no, tell me please what you want. I want you to be in my film. Ramchand is making this Saira, and it's a wonderful subject. And you are, I want you to be my guru character. It's a special character. Maybe maximum 1 week time will take. He said immediately, Chiranjeevi, you don't ask anything, you never ask anything. Since you are asking, I said, I'll say yes. And he, so great, and immediately he responded. He said, send your team to me, I want to discuss the rest of the things. And I sent director and other people, I sent them. And immediately he said yes. I'm so happy, really, my heartfelt thanks to the Indian megastar, Amitabh Bachchanji.
Thank you so much, sir. I think it'll be a treat to watch both of you together. Thank you.
Hi, Ritesh. Ritesh here. There's a question for you. You got us, you know, you guys got us KGF, and you presented the entire film in a grand way, and now you guys are part, with part of this grand film. So what's the selection process? How do you guys select, you know, these films? And secondly, will we see you producing a South Indian film, a collaboration, you know, in a big way with Hindi film actors and this some presenting in a much grander way?
Like I said, firstly, I think the content, when Charan, Anil spoke to us, and Charan had this idea of, you know, taking the film beyond just the South market and the South languages. I saw the trailer, and like the teaser which you're seeing now, I think it's a story which was of an unsung hero. It's like the first rebel against the British, set in the 18th century. So I really liked what I saw. And then he took me through, I had not seen the film at that point, he took me through what the film was, and I saw various portions of it, and I was completely like in love with it, and I said, okay, this is something we should do. And I was glad that he, you know, like chose us to actually present the film. So it was, it worked the other way. After seeing the material, we were really hopeful that he'll say that you guys should present it. So thank you. But that was there. And yes, why not? We, I mean, if we get a script and we can collaborate on a film which right from the script level rather than just coming on, we are completely open to that.
Hi, Farhan. On your left. On your left. Hi. Hi. Faridun from Balanangama. So Farhan, you're saying that there are enough screens that we have. See, we are having around 5,000 screens for Hindi. And you've experienced it with Rais and...
Right. I think your question is very detailed. You should ask Anil Thadani this question.
Okay. I think I can ask both of you and Ritesh as well. I think even I think Anil Thadani can answer as well. So the idea is that even with Rais and Kabil came together, so there was a day when I think you guys had around 26 crores in a day, and it was running to capacity. If there were more screens, you could have done more business. We've seen in Mission Mangal and Batla House, Mission Mangal Sunday was extraordinary, but if more screens were there, the business would have been higher. So what efforts do you think should be done to just raise the number of screens, because China is way ahead of us and we are just not doing enough maybe?
You have multiple questions in your first question, huh? So we'll have to think.
And you've also answered it in your question.
No, but I think ultimately you guys will have to take the initiative. We can say, but the initiative has to come from you guys.
You know, see, regarding the theaters, you're absolutely right. It is something we've, when we went and met our government recently, just before the elections, and when the GST issue was there, and we went and spoke to them, and I think they have understood what happens with cinemas, and what, especially in your rural city towns, because there are, either we are over-screened in Mumbai city and Delhi, where you have more screens, and there are a lot of places where we don't have screens. Yeah. So I think they've understood that. And like China, like you're absolutely right, China and India were on par till 2011, when we had the same average number of screens for the population, and they have obviously grown a lot. So I think, yes, there is a plan in place, but again, when you are talking about Rais, or you are talking about Kabil, which released the same day, I think both were good films. If somebody went and saw Kabil on Thursday, they went and saw Rais the next day. So it's not that I did not get tickets, and there was one box office you mentioned was 25 crores and the other was... I think as long as both films are something which they want to watch, they'll go and watch it. It's not that because I've seen one, I won't see the other. Right? So I don't think we have that issue. of worrying, like even what Farhan said earlier, both will be good films. People will want to watch both. I mean, I'm sure you must have gone to in a week and watched two movies, right? You wouldn't only go to one film if they were there.
It's so also I don't accessibility. Many a times people want to watch it, but the cinema screens are not, especially in the smaller cities, as you've rightly said.
Yeah,
the,
but you can go next day.
Cinema screens are less. They're not enough cinema screens, maybe, and because of that, people are unable to see it.
I think they'll watch it the next day, and if it's not available on that screen, I'm sure it'll be available. It's not that it's never happened that in the same town or in the same pin code, you'll not find another screen. I don't think that's ever happened. So it's at the most, you'll be a little more of effort. And I think if the movie is that exciting, you'll put in that little extra effort.
Thank you, so do you.
Thank you so much.
And so
I have
all
to
you lovely people out there in the audience.
Woo-hoo!
Is everyone excited for the teaser? I'm super excited. Are you guys excited? Lovely.
Everybody is so happy they're taking a selfie also of themselves. I'm very happy. Okay. So I have to ask you a question, Tamanna. I have seen glimpses of the teaser. Okay. And you are doing some fantastic action sequences. Are you ready to be the generation's new action figure?
Darasal, ye film mein mera kirdar puri tarah se alag hai. Shayad iske pehle jo period film maine ki hai, jo sabne bahut hi जिसको सबने बहुत ही प्यार दिया है, बहुत ही सराहा है, उसके बाद मैं बहुत खुश हूँ कि सायरा के साथ मेरा नाम जुड़ा, बिकॉज सायरा इज अ स्टोरी दैट पीपल शुड नो अबाउट. इट्स अबाउट एन हीरो दैट पीपल डोंट नो अबाउट एंड शुड नो अबाउट फ्रॉम द फ्रीडम फाइट दैट वी हैड. सो बहुत गर्व होता है, बहुत खुशी है कि आज मैं इस फिल्म का हिस्सा हूँ. And I can't wait. जब आप टीजर देखेंगे, I hope आपको पसंद आए. And yeah,
we're waiting for the film also. So we're waiting over here only for the release of the film also. Thank you so much, Tamanna. Can we please give a huge round of applause?
It was the right opportunity. It did present itself with this film. But I think more importantly, when I was growing up, I grew up on a very healthy diet of movies that were not just Hindi movies. You know, my mom had a great collection of movies that were from all different parts of the world in different languages. And you get to learn something about different cultures, about different identities. And when you watch those films, you know, and I do feel that right now, the world, the way it is, I mean, we're in a place where there seems to be a growing number of boundaries being put up. So it's nice that people in art and people in film are tearing boundaries down and exchanging films and exchanging creative and cultural ideas.
Thank you so much, Farhan. Thank you so much. Can we please call upon the next person, an inspiring entrepreneur, an exceptional producer. He takes risks, he plunges to bring us films that are etched in our memories forever. Dil Chahta Hai completed 18 years a couple of days ago. Of course, Farhan was also responsible for it. But this man was also responsible and he had his birthday. So, bless.
Good evening. Stardom, I don't think, is for those who believe that acting is performance is not all about stardom. If you look at the poster, the biggest is right here, Mr. B. I don't think we all can cope up to anything of their achievements, and I guess sharing spaces with such wonderful people and actors from all across is a best thing that can happen to any actor.
Would you pinch yourself every day on set that I'm working on this finally?
Come
oh my
again,
God.
I didn't hear you.
Would you pinch yourself on set to believe that this is true, this is finally happening to you as well?
Every time we would look into the mirror after getting ready, it was difficult to believe it was us. So much of beard, so much of what we are not, carrying ourselves and, you know, the costumes weighing so much of heaviness, I guess, you know. The best part is some days, couple of days, when the war sequences are happening, I guess, every time we met another actor, it would take a little more fewer seconds to understand who that person is. You know, it was
Who
like
are you
that.
Fighting with?
Everybody. Literally ourselves later, you know, so it's very difficult to identify people at times, you know, with all the get up and other things. But it was fun because it's such a magnanimous film and I guess doesn't happen every day. So when you get an opportunity to be a part of it, I think we should just close our eyes and be a part of it.
I just have to thank you for being a part of it too. So thank you so much, Sudeep.
Thank you, ma'am.
The next person thank who's you. Going to come on stage is a member of the parliament, a major hand in giving Bhojpuri cinema pan-India recognition. With a career spanning over 3 decades, he has starred in Hindi, Telugu, Kannada, Tamil, and Bhojpuri films. Can we please put our hands